Hi everyone, welcome back to Frappe School. My name is Lynette Sharon and this is the 10th chapter in our Advanced Accounting course. By the end of this chapter, we will be able to understand how we can manage shareholders in ERP Next. Shareholders play an essential role as an individual or an organization who owns shares in a company. Unico Plastics, which is a manufacturer of plastic furniture, recently received an IPO which has opened the option for shareholders to purchase shares. Since managing the data of the shareholders to streamline the process is a tedious task, ERP Next Shareholder Management allows the issue and transfer of each share of the company, allowing you to get the share ledger and track complete history. Let's see how we can manage the same using ERP Next. To create a shareholder in ERP Next, we need to navigate to the shareholder list and click on New. Enter the name of the shareholder and click on Save. Once saved, we will get an option to add address and contact details. Once added, click on Save again. Unico Plastics has recently invited new shareholders via IPO, which has changed the existing proportion of shareholders. Because of this change, our shareholder, Belenco Inc., is transferring its issued shares to another company. Let's see how we can add these details in ERP Next. To add the share transfer, let's search for it from the awesome bar. Add a new transfer and first set the transfer type. For the first ever shareholder transaction, this will be issue. Set the date for the transfer. Select the from and to shareholders and the folio numbers. Set the liability and asset accounts. The share type, whether preference or equity, and select the number of shares to be transferred. Add the rate of one share. The amount will be calculated based on the number of shares. Once all the details are added, click on Save and Submit. Let's look at some reports that can be generated using the data that we have captured. The first report is the share balance report. This is a report view that gives a list of all the shares held by a given shareholder and their value. The second report is the share ledger. This is a report view that gives the list of all the transactions made by a given shareholder. This brings us to the end of the 10th chapter of our Advanced Accounting course. I hope this helped you understand how we can manage shareholders efficiently using ERP Next. You can read more about ERP Next on docs.erpnext.com. In the next chapter, we will discuss subscription management. Thank you.